Life processes in living organism, part first. In this topic, what we are going to study, that is the living organisms and life processes, then the living organisms and energy production, some nutrients and energy efficiency, cell division, a life process. In this topic, we see the various points. Then, we have studied various life processes in the previous standard. Just recall them. What are the foodstuffs and their nutrient content which are useful for our body? We eat various food materials like fruits, vegetables, chapati, roti, rice, and that contains various nutrients which are helpful for our body, that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals, vitamins. What is the importance of the balanced diet for the body? What is the balanced diet? The diet which includes all the constituents of the food which are necessary for the development of our body, that we call the balanced diet. Then what is the importance? If we take some food and which doesn't include all these constituents of the food which are essential for our body, that causes the various disorders. And so we eat a balanced diet daily. Then what different functions are performed by muscles in the body? The muscles which are present in our body that are helpful for the movement, for doing work, for physical work, and so on. What is the importance of the digestive juices in our digestive system? There are various digestive juices. Some they are secreted in the stomach, some in a small intestine. And these digestive juices helps to digest the food which we eat. The food which we eat that contains carbohydrates, proteins, fat, that should be digested. And for the digestion of this food, these various digestive juices, they helps to digest that food. Then, which is the system is in action for the removal of the waste material which are produced in our body, that is the excretory system, that helps to remove the unwanted, unnecessary waste which are produced in our body in a form of urine and the waste material in the various forms. Then the role of the circulatory system in the energy production, that as we know that we eat the food which get digested, and the digested food should be supplied to each and every cell of our body, and for that supply, the circulatory system helps. The digested food, that is glucose, fatty acids, amino acid, they get supplied to the each and every cell of our body. And whereas there is a energy production by the process of the respiration, then that is how are the various processes occurring in our human body get controlled, in how many ways? The various life processes in our body that get controlled by the nervous system and by the chemical system. There are certain chemicals which regulates the life processes, or in our body there is a system. Then living organisms and the life processes is the next point. As we know that the difference between living and non-living we have studied in the various standards. In the living organism, various systems they work together and to perform the function of the body. The various systems like digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, excretory system, nervous system, there are various systems which work together with a coordination and perform the function of the body. That for the performation of these functions, our body needs the energy, and we need the energy for the various systems, and so we eat the various foodstuffs to obtain the energy. From that foodstuff, we obtain the carbohydrates, fats, lipids, which are the main sources of the energy. Other, that is minerals, vitamins, they are also essential for the functioning of the various life processes in our body. Green plants, which we call the autotrophs, as we know that they produce their own food by the process of the photosynthesis with the help of sunlight, chlorophyll pigment, carbon dioxide, etc. The animals that we call the autotrophs, as they depend on the other plants and animals for their food, and so they are called the autotrophs. His various organs, they take part in a respiratory system, and through that we obtain the energy. Then carbohydrates, as we know that it is the food that we consume every day that are mainly utilized for the production of the energy and which is essential for the daily work, daily need. The energy is obtained in the form of ATP, that is ATP are the adenosine triphosphate molecules, which we call the energy currency molecules or the energy molecules. And for that purpose, this carbohydrate that should be get converted into glucose, a type of the carbohydrate. Cellular respiration that occurs among the living organism by two methods. These two methods, which are called the aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration that takes place in the presence of oxygen, and in anaerobic respiration, oxygen is not involved in the process of the respiration. What is the respiration? Respiration is a process by which we get energy from the assimilated food. Respiration is the life process by which we obtain the energy from the assimilated food. That energy is in the form of ATPs. That is we call the respiration. Then in the respiration process, there are various steps. First step, which we call the glycolysis. Glycolysis means breakdown of the glucose. Glucose is a 6 carbon compound which get breakdown into the 3 carbon compound that we call the pyruvic acid. In this process, we get 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, 2 molecules of ATP, 2 molecules of NADH2 and water molecule also. The glycolysis process is same in both type of the respiration, that is in aerobic respiration and in anaerobic respiration. In both type of respiration, glycolysis is the same process which occur in a both type of the respiration. Then in this process, as we see that we obtain the 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, 2 molecules of ATP, 2 molecules of NADH2, 2 molecules of water. In this process, the pyruvic acid that get converted into acetyl coenzyme A, and by this process 2 NADH2 and 2 carbon dioxide molecules get released. Then the next step in the process of the respiration, that we call the tricarboxylic acid cycle. The 2 molecules of the acetyl coenzyme A that get enter into the mitochondria. Note here, the process of glycolysis that takes place in a cytoplasm. Where the process of glycolysis completes in a cytoplasm, and the molecules of the acetyl coenzyme A that get enter into the mitochondria, and then the next steps of this respiration that carried into the mitochondria. Mitochondria, as we know, that it is the powerhouse of the cell, as it produces the power that is in the form of ATPs. The various cyclic chains of these reactions that are called the tricarboxylic acid cycle, and which is operated on it in the mitochondria. The acetyl part of the coenzyme A get completely oxidized through these cyclic processes, and molecules of this carbon dioxide, water, NADH2, FADH2, they are derived in this process of the tricarboxylic acid cycle. This is also known as the Krebs cycle, as it is invented by the scientist Krebs. Then the next step in the process of the respiration is the electron transfer chain reaction. Molecules of the NADH2 and FADH2, which are formed during the glycolysis and TCA cycle, they get participate in the electron transfer chain reaction, and due to this, three molecules of the ATPs are obtained from each NADH2 molecule, and two molecules of ATP from each FADH2 molecule. Beside this, ATP water molecules are also formed in this reaction. This electron transfer reaction, it is operated in mitochondria only, and thus the molecule of glucose is completely oxidized in aerobic respiration, and molecules of the carbon dioxide, water, they are produced along with the NLC. In anaerobic respiration, there is an incomplete oxidation of the glucose molecule, and therefore there is a production of less amount of the energy, that is only two molecules of ATP they get produced in the anaerobic respiration. But in aerobic respiration, there are 38 ATPs are formed in this complete oxidation of this glucose molecule. Here, how this process takes place in a various food constituents, that is, here is a aerobic respiration, that is, and here is the anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, the main source of energy is the carbohydrate. If there is a lack of carbohydrate, or in a illness, if there is a lack of carbohydrates present in the body, then our body starts to consume lipids and proteins also. From the 1 gram of the carbohydrate, we obtain 4 kilocalories of the energy from in this process. In the glycolysis process, that is, carbohydrate get converted into pyruvic acid, and pyruvic acid get converted into acetyl coenzyme A, and that acetyl coenzyme A enter into the mitochondria, and where the Krebs cycle get completed, that is the TCA cycle and ETC cycle. Then from this process, we obtain the carbon dioxide, water molecules, and energy, that is 38 energy we obtain here in the process of aerobic respiration. If there is a lack of carbohydrate in our body by the various processes or by the various ways, our body starts to consume the lipids and proteins also. That lipids get converted into fatty acids, and fatty acids get converted into acetyl coenzyme A, and the next cycle is the same. Here also proteins get converted into amino acids, and amino acids get converted into acetyl coenzyme A, and the next process is as same in a, that is in a carbohydrates also. This is the aerobic respiration that takes place in the body. In the anaerobic respiration takes place by the various microorganisms like yeast, then some various microorganisms or microbes, our erythrocytes, that is RBCs, and muscle cells, they also perform the anaerobic respiration. In this process, glucose gets converted, as we have seen that the process of glycolysis is same in both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. After the glycolysis, this pyruvic acid is get fermented and that converted into the alcohol by the yeast cells, and two molecules of ATPs are formed here in this anaerobic respiration. In a various microorganisms, various products are formed like vinegar, vitamins, with that two molecules of ATPs are also produced. Here is the process is the same, glycolysis. After that, pyruvic acid get converted into various products by the process of fermentation. In the muscle cells or in the erythrocytes, that pyruvic acid after fermentation get converted into lactic acid, and so we feel tired when we do exercise or excessive exercise, as our body required more energy for that exercise, and if it is less in amount, so our muscle starts to respire by the anaerobic process, and there is a production of the lactic acid, and we feel tired in exercise.